Hi everyone, welcome back to our online English class. Today I don't teach you a new lesson. Today we revise the lesson 192 because your exam is very near. When is your exam? It is on August 3rd Monday our exam begins, and Tuesday is your exam. Tuesday you have your English exam. How many lessons are there for your exam? Lessons 1 and 2. Okay, today I would like to give you the revision of the lesson 2 at first, because other lesson, the first lesson you studied in many classes, the lesson 2 you studied in one class. So I would like to give you the revision of the lesson 2 at first. Okay, get ready for the revision. Lesson 2, the poem, First Day at School. I'm going to read the poem. I wonder if my drawing will be as good as theirs. I wonder if they'll like me or just be full of stares. I wonder if my teacher will look like mom or grand. I wonder if my puppy will wonder where I am. I hope you could understand something in the last class. Okay, now I'd like to read it again and I'm going to explain it once again. Okay, I wonder if my drawing will be as good as theirs. Yes, it is as usual when we go to a new school, when we visit a new place, we may have some problem. Okay, we don't know the place, we don't know the people, we don't know anything about that, situation. So you may have anxieties like that. The poet, Eileen Fisher, the speaker of the poem, is having some problems on her first day at school, and she has doubts. She is not sure about anything. She is always having doubts. I wonder if my drawing will be as good as theirs. Okay, she has doubt. She is not sure that her drawing will be good. Her picture will be good like her friend's pictures. I wonder if my drawing will be as good as theirs. Who are theirs? Her classmates. Theirs are her classmates. I wonder if they'll like me or just be full of stares. I wonder if they'll like me or just be full of stares. And what does the speaker say? The speaker is saying, I wonder if they'll like me or just be full of stares. She's not sure that her classmates will like her. Okay, they, again, the word is here, they. Who are they? Her classmates. I wonder, I'm not sure that my classmates will like me or just be full of stares. And she's thinking, sometimes they may stare at her. What's the meaning of the word stare? To look at something or someone for a long time. Okay, to look at someone in an unfriendly way. Okay, namukku parichayam illatha notam le oraalu pudhiya oraalu namukku parichayam illatha oraalu kaanumbol ayaalu nokkunna reethi le stare. Don't stare at me. He stared at me. Okay, you wrote the sentence. Stare, what's the meaning? Say all of you. Stare, what's the meaning? To look at something or someone for a long time. Okay, S-T-A-R-E. He stares, I stare, they stare. Okay, he stared at me. Okay, I wonder if they'll like me or just be full of stares. Sometimes they will stare at me because I'm new to the class. The children, her classmates, don't know her. That's why sometimes they may stare at her. She's thinking like that. Okay, the next, I wonder if my teacher will look like mom or grand. Yes, she is new to the class. She doesn't know her teachers. She doesn't know her friends. And here she is thinking she wants her teacher like her mother or grandmother. If the teacher is like her mother or grandmother, she would not be so nervous. Okay, that's why she wants her teacher like her mom or grandmother. Okay. The next, I wonder if my puppy will wonder where I am. Yes, what pet does she have? Does the speaker have? She has a puppy. Okay. Here usually she plays with the puppy. For the first time she comes to school. So puppy puppy might wonder where she is because she is not at home to play with it. Okay. The speaker is not at home to play with the puppy. That's why the puppy might wonder where she is. Usually she plays with the puppy. But that day, she is not there to play with it. That's why the puppy might wonder where she is. Okay, the puppy might think, why, where is my friend? Where is the speaker? Okay, the puppy might wonder where the speaker is, where the point is. Okay, I wonder if my drawing will be as good as theirs. I wonder if they'll like me or just be full of stares. I wonder if my teacher will look like mom or grand. I wonder if my puppy will wonder where I am. Okay, you please read with me. All of you, read loudly. Some of you don't read loudly. Whatever I say, some of you don't do that. You simply watch the video. Read it loudly. Okay. I wonder. See, I wonder if my drawing will be as good as theirs. Will be as good as theirs. I wonder if they like me. If they like me. We can use the short form, contracted form. They like me or just be full of stares. My friends may stare at me. I wonder if my teacher, okay, read with me. I wonder if my teacher will look like mom or grand. I wonder if my puppy will wonder where I am. Who is the poet? Eileen Fisher. Okay, I hope now you could understand the poem. Okay, now let's discuss the new words, meaning, sentences, whatever it is. Okay, whatever things in the notebook. Okay. Yes. Only one word I gave you to study the meaning. What is that? Stare. What is the word? Stare. Study now itself. Spell the word stare. S-T-A-R-E. All of you say. S-T-A-R-E. What's the meaning? To look at. Something or someone for a long time. To look at something or someone for a long time. What's the meaning stare? To look at something or someone for a long time. And what's the sentence? You can write, you are free to make any meaningful sentence. I gave you the sentence. He stared at me. What is the sentence? He stared full stop. When we complete the sentence, we have to put full stop. And when we begin the sentence, capital letter is a must. Okay. Begin the sentence with a capital letter. And when you finish the sentence, there must be a full stop. Okay. And we can underline the word used in sentence. He stared at me. Okay, he stared at me. Only one word to study the meaning. And I hope you studied it now itself. Then I gave you four verb forms. Let us discuss that. Stare. What's the V2 form? Stare. Yes, you take care of the spelling. Many spelling mistakes I found in your notebook. Don't make mistakes. Stare. Then like. Liked. Okay, your letters must be legible. I have to read it. So write carefully. Most of you write neatly. But some are careless in writing. Do it neatly. Then look. Looked. Wonder. Okay. W-O-N-D-E-R. You have to add E-D. Wonder. Okay. Then some opposites also I gave you. which are the opposites. Good. What's opposite? What's opposite? Bad. Good. Opposite. Bad. Next. Like. What's opposite? Like. Dislike. Okay. Like. Dislike. Next one. Full. What's opposite? Empty. Hi, no, like it is empty, nothing inside it. Empty, empty. Take care of the spelling. Spelling is a must. Okay, you must write the correct spelling. Empty. Empty. Okay, empty. Empty. Full opposite, empty. Okay. Once again, we can read good, bad, like. Dislike, full, empty. Okay. Next, answer the following. I'll read the question and let's discuss the answers. What does to wonder mean? What does to wonder mean? What's the meaning? It means to be unsure. It means to be unsure, not sure about that. I'm not sure about that. Okay. What does the poet want her classmates to do? What does the poet want her classmates to do? The poet want her classmates to like her. You have to begin the sentence with a capital letter. Put full stop at the end of the sentence. Okay. Don't forget that. And third question. Why might the speaker's pet wonder where she is? Because you can write in a simple way. Because the speaker is not there to play with the puppy. Okay, the speaker is not at home to play with the puppy. If you have any difficulty to write the complete sentences, you can write like this. But the correct sentence is, the speaker's pet wonders where she is because the speaker is not at home to play with it, to play with the puppy. Okay, this is the correct way. But if you have any problem to write in this way, you can write because the speaker is not at home to play with the puppy. Okay. Understood all of you? This is how, and some who choose the correct answer questions may come from this poem. When you write exams in Google form, you attended some questions like that. You selected some correct answers. I gave you some options and you selected some answers. That way, some questions may come from this form. Okay. Have you understood this one? Okay. You must collect the rolled paper now itself. Okay, and for exam, you will be sent a question paper. You get the question paper and write in the answer sheet neatly. Now you have to write your name, class, division, subject, date, everything. Then put the correct number, what is given in the question paper, what number is given. That way you have to write neatly. Neatness is a must. And then you have to send it to my WhatsApp number. Okay, understand, you have to WhatsApp it. Okay, that will, again I will inform you, and this to understand, collected in a nice rolled paper, keep it with you. Okay, understood all of you? Now let's go to the lesson 1. Okay. Okay, now completed the revision of the lesson 2. Now let's go to the lesson 1. I think it is very familiar to you, but we can revise it once again. Okay. First day at school. I'll read the lesson, okay? Just listen carefully. Alima was nervous. It was her first day at Vidyamandir. Priya Kamath was in the same class as she had promised to introduce Alima to everyone. But Alima could not see her anyway. Then Priya came running up the stairs. Sorry, I'm late, she panted. I didn't wake up on time today. She grabbed Alima by the hand and pulled her into a classroom nearby. The bell rang and Mrs. Sen, the class teacher, walked in. Good morning, children, she said. Good morning, teacher, said Priya. This is Alima Momin, our new class teacher. Sorry, our new classmate. Hello, Alima, said Mrs. Sen kindly. Good morning, said Alima, smiling shyly. Let Alima sit next to you, Priya, said Mrs. Sen. Soon, all the students sat in their places. Children, I want you to meet your new classmate, said Mrs. Sen. Priya, will you please introduce her? Then we can all introduce ourselves. This is Alima Momin, said Priya. She stopped and looked at Alima for help. Shillong, said Alima, smiling. Priya laughed. I'm sorry. I should know that. You see, Alima's father and my father work in the same office. That's how I met her. Thank you, Priya, said Mrs. Sen. Who's next? I'm Deep Singh Gill, said a boy in a small turban. I am from Chandigarh. My name is Nina Fernandez. I am from Panaji, said a girl in two ponytails. Salim Rizvi from Lucknow, said a boy in spectacles. Soon, everyone had introduced themselves. Only you and I are left, Priya, said Mrs. Sen. I'm Priya Kamath and I'm from Bangalore, said Priya quickly. And I'm Maitri Sen and I'm from Kolkata, said Mrs. Sen. She spread a big map of India on her table. Now, let's find out the places we are from on this map, she said. Okay, I think no need to explain this once again. I think all of you understood the lesson. Now, let's discuss the words, their meanings, sentences, verb forms, opposites, and so the following, and the grammar part. Okay? Now, let's discuss the words and their meanings. Okay? Nervous. What's the meaning of this word nervous? A little worried. What's the meaning? A little worried. And what's the sentence you wrote there in your notebook? Alima was nervous. I told you to make sentence, you are free. You can make any sentence. You can write your own sentence, no problem. Okay? But begin the sentence with a capital letter and put a full stop at the end of the sentence. Okay. Alima was nervous. What is the first word? Nervous. Nervous is the first word. Nervous. Okay. Nervous. What's the word? Nervous. What's the meaning? A little worried. A little worried. Alima was nervous. I'm nervous. Anything you can write. Then, panted. What is the V1 form of this verb? Panted. Pant. Pant. What's the meaning? Breathe quickly. Pant. Breathe quickly. Panted. Breathed quickly. When we say pant, we have to use the V1 form of the verb of breathe. Breathe quickly. Panted. Breathed quickly. Okay? Panted. What's the second word? Panted. P-A-N-T-E-D. Not D. This is T. Not D. P-A-N-D. No. Okay? P-A-N-T. Panted. Okay? Panted. What's the meaning? Breathed quickly. B-R-E-A-T-H-E-D. Breathed quickly. Okay. Breathed quickly. What's the sentence? Which sentence you wrote in the book? He panted when he reached the top. When he ran fast, he panted heavily. Okay. When he ran fast, he panted heavily. You can write any sentence, no problem. You can choose the simple sentence. Okay. And next, grabbed. Grabbed. What's the third one? Grabbed. Grab. Grab is the V1 form of the verb. Grab. Catch quickly. Grab means catch quickly. Grabbed, the V2 form of the verb catch. Caught quickly. Okay. Grabbed, caught quickly. Okay. What's the meaning? Caught quickly. He grabbed my sweets. She grabbed my sweets. Okay. Any sentence you can write. No problem. Then, now let's discuss the verb forms. Promise. form of this verb promise, promised, promised, promise, promised, promised. Then introduce, introduced, introduced. Take care of the spelling. Okay. Then run, run, ran, run. Okay, your letters must be legible. Every time I tell you this, but some of you are very careless about the handwriting. Okay, do neatly, do it legibly. Means in a way you can avoid a clear out. Okay, that way you have to write. Grab, G-R-A-B, grab. And when you write the V2 form, there is, what's the spelling? Double B is there, okay. Grab, grabbed, grab, G-R-A-B-B-E-D. Right here. Grab, grab, crash. Okay, take care. When I check your notebooks, I found these mistakes. That's why I am repeating. Grab. What's the need for? Grab. Double B there. Okay, grab. G-R-A-B-B-E-D. Then third form also? Grab. Okay, grab, grab, grab. Understood? The next one, sit, sit, sat, sat. Then pull, pull, pulled, pulled. P-U-L-L-E-D, P-U-L-L-E-D, pulled. Then meet. What's our V2 form? Meet. Meet is a V1 form. Meet, met, met, met. To add E-D, it is easy to write. But this type of verbs, you have to take care of meet. Met, met. The next, stop. S-T-O-P. S-T-O-P. Okay, take care of the spelling. Okay, these are the mistakes I found in your notebook. Stop, stop. The double P there. Okay, S-T-O-P-P-E-D. Stop. Stop. Okay, stop, stop, stop. Okay, then what is next? No. K no W no. What's the V2 form? No. K no W no. New. A N E W no. New. A N E. New. And the third form? No. K no W N. K no W N. No. K no W N. You look. No. New. No. K no W no. K-E-W, new. K-O-W, and non. No, new, non. Say all of you. No, new, non. Okay. Then what is next? Say. Say. Yes. I write here. Say. Say. Sit. S-A-I-D. S-A-I-D. Say. Sit. G-R-A-B-B-E-D. Okay. Then meet, met, met. M-E-T. Okay. Meet, met, met. M-W-E-T. Okay. M-W-E-T. Meet. Kandupukkudu. Meet. 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 Met. Met. Stop. Stopped. Double P there. S-T-O-P-P-E-D. Stopped. Stopped. No. New. Non, K, no, W, N. Then last one, say, sit, sit. Okay, have you understood? Now, let's discuss the opposite words, okay?
Second one.
nervous. N-E-R-V-O-U-S. Nervous, relaxed. Nervous, relaxed. What's opposite? Relaxed. Nervous. The tension is a failure. Relaxed. Nervous, relaxed. And third one. What's the third one? Late. What's the opposite of this word? Late. Late. L-A-T-E. Late. What's the opposite? Early. Late. E-A-R-L-Y. E-A-R-L-Y. Late. Early. What's the opposite? Late. Early. Then four. Fourth one. N-E-A-R-B-Y. Nearby, opposite. Far away. Nearby, far away, ugly. Nearby, opposite. Far away. Far away. Nearby, opposite. Far away. Fifth one. New. What's opposite? New. Old. New. Old. Then sixth one. Kind. What's the opposite of this word? Kind. Unkind. Kind. Kind. Unkind. Okay. Kind. Unkind. Shy. Nanangudiyale. Shy. Bold. Thairyam. Shy. Shy. Bold. B-O-L-D. Shy, opposite, bold. Then, eighth one. Same. S-A-M-E. Same. Same. What's opposite? Same. Different. D-I-F-F-E-R-E-N-T. Same. Different. Then, nine. Just a ninth one. Small. Small. What's the opposite of this word? Small. Big. Small. Big. Okay. Small. Big. Then last one. Quickly. Quickly. Slowly. Quickly. Slowly. So let's read it once again. First, last. Nervous, relaxed. Late, early. Nearby, far away. New, old. Kind, unkind. Shy, bold. Same, different. Small, big. Then quickly, slowly. Okay? Did you study this? Have you studied all these opposites? Study well. Prepare well for the exam. Okay. Now, let's discuss this answer of these questions. Okay. Now, let's discuss this answer of these questions. All of you look at the textbook. What's the first question? What was the name of the new student? You all know the answer and you know the name of the student. Okay. The new student was Alima Momin. When you get this type of questions, I don't want any one word answer. Okay. You have to write the answer in complete sentence. What's the question? What was the name of the new student? So how will you write the answer? The new student was Alima Momin. The name of the new student was Alima Momin. I want the complete sentence. Begin the sentence with a capital letter, with a full stop at the end of the sentence. Okay. And where was she from? She was from. This way you have to begin. She was from. She was from Shillong. Shillong is the name of a place. So you have to begin the word Shillong with a capital letter. S must be a capital letter. Shillong. Okay. Second one. Why was Priya Kamath late to school? Priya Kamath was late to school because she two ways you can write the answer. Because she didn't wake up on time that day. Okay, she didn't wake up on time that day. Okay, you can make your own sentence. I don't want the same sentence I gave you in the notebook. I want a correct answer. That's all. Okay. How did Priya help the new students? How did Priya help? In the question, how did Priya help? So in the answer, you have to write Priya helped. Okay, how did she help? Priya helped the new student by introducing her to everyone in the class. Like introducing her to her classmates. Okay. Yes, Priya helped. H-E-L-P-E-D must be there. Okay. What did Mrs. Sen, the class teacher, ask all the students to do? Mrs. Sen, M must be a capital letter. Sen, S must be a capital letter. Okay. Mrs. Sen, the class teacher, what did she ask all the students to do? She asked all the students to introduce themselves to Alima. Alima, A must be a capital letter. Okay, don't forget this. Alima, Momin, A. The letter A and Momin, M. Okay, they must be in capital letter. You have to begin with the capital letter. Okay, Salim, Rizvi, S capital letter, R capital letter. Okay, you have to take care, when you write, you have to take very much care about the spelling, about the capital letter, about the small letter like that, okay. And read this description. I think this, all these answers, you know that. The boy with the turban, the girl with the ponytails, the girl who introduced the new girl, the boy with spectacles, the new girl's name, all these answers you have already studied. Okay. Then now let's go to the difficult part, the plurals. Okay, you can expect questions from this plural part. Okay, you have to write the plural words. Okay, the word will be there and your singular form will be there and you have to write the plural word. Okay, then which are the words here, just to go through this. Class, classes. Bus, buses. Then students, students. Room, rooms. Then man, men. Knife, knives. Tooth, teeth. Flower, flowers. Fox, foxes. Clothes, clothes. Then story. We can add IES in the place of the letter Y. We can add IES. Story, stories. Family, families. Baby, babies. Pony, ponies. Lady, ladies. Take care of the spelling. You have to add IES. Lady. We have to remove the letter Y and you have to add IES in the place of the letter Y. Ladies. Puppies. Berries. Okay. Body, bodies. Battery, batteries. City, cities. Lily, lilies. Jelly, jellies. Worry, worries. Okay. Compound nouns. You can expect a question from this part also. No need to give any definition or anything. Okay. Sometimes you have to write an example. Okay. Compound words. Okay. Two words are joined together to make a single word. Which are the examples given here? Classmate. Bookshelf. Okay. Then dustbin. Cardboard. Doorstep. Haircut. Here we have to match this and I think we got the answer. Shoelace. Eyebrow. Bedroom. Earring. E-A-R-R-I-N-G. Take care. Okay. Earring. Then sunlight. Okay. Shoelace. Eyebrow. Bedroom. Earring. And sunlight. Okay. Then so all the important things I discussed and I told you to study the composition, myself. The topic is myself. You can make any meaningful sentences on this topic, myself. Okay. And I told you when you write your name, listen here. For example, I write my name on the board. My name is full stop here. Okay, you have to write like this. After the initial, you can put a full stop. Okay, Babita P dot K dot. Okay, don't put any dot here. Okay, and when you write your parents' name, my father is Mr. Okay, Mr. Then you write, for example, Sanju. Mr. Sanju. S. S must be a capital letter. Mr. Sanju. If you want, you can put a dot, or if you don't put a dot, it's not a mistake. Okay. Mr. Sanju. S capital. M capital. So, mother's name. Mrs. Okay. Then you begin with a capital letter. Okay. Don't forget that. And I'll give you the model questions. Okay. I'll give you the model questions. And which are the lessons? Lessons 1 and 2. Model questions. Which are the model questions? I'll tell you. You have to write meanings and sentences. You have to write meanings and sentences. Meanings and sentences. And don't forget to write the sentence. Usually I see some children write meaning, but they forget to write the sentence. You have to write the sentence also. Don't forget that. And after using the word in sentence, please underline the word. Okay? First you have to write meaning and sentence. Then you have to write the verb forms. Okay, the verb forms. Okay, V2, V3 forms of the verb. Then C. You have to write the opposite words. You have to write the opposite words. Then. And then maybe choose the correct answer questions. Okay. From the textbook some questions will be given. You have to choose the correct one. Okay. Choose the correct answer questions. Choose the correct answer then. And there will be questions from plural. Okay, drama part plurals. You will have to write a correct plural word. Okay, study about plurals. Okay, drama. Plurals and compound. Plurals and compound noun. Compound words. Okay, you will have to study about plurals and compound nouns. Okay, then there will be the composition. Okay, here I'll give you to write a few sentences on the topic myself. Okay, prepare that. Okay, composition. Then answer the following questions. From these two lessons, some questions will be asked. Okay, from textbook, after the lesson, in the textbook, some questions are given that you study very well. Okay, answer the following questions. Answer the following. Okay, total marks 25. Okay, study very well, prepare well. I want a nice mark in your paper. Your writing must be legible. Do neatly. After each section, draw a neat line. Okay? Study. I wish you all the best. I hope all will get a nice mark in your pre-midterm examination. Okay. Thank you.